We want to solve the compound inequality and then express the solution using interval notation. Notice this compound inequality consists of two inequalities connected by the word or, which means the solution will consist of all the values that satisfy the inequality on the left, as well as all the values that satisfy the inequality on the right. So what we'll do is solve each of these individually and then graph both on the number line to interpret the results. So we'll first solve the inequality 5x minus 12 is less than 8. And then we'll solve the inequality negative 2x plus 1 is less than or equal to negative 5. So to isolate x on the left side here, we'll start by adding 12 to both sides. This would be 0, so we have 5x is less than 20. And now we'll divide both sides by positive 5. So we have x is less than positive 4. So now let's go ahead and graph this interval in blue. Notice that 4 does not satisfy this inequality because 4 is not less than 4. So we'll make an open point on 4, which means 4 is not included in this interval. And for values less than 4, we'll have an arrow to the left. Now we'll go ahead and solve the red inequality. So we'll start by subtracting 1 on both sides. This would be 0, so we have negative 2x is less than or equal to, this would be negative 6. And now we'll divide both sides by negative 2. And because we're dividing by a negative, we do have to reverse the inequality symbol. So here we have x, and now it's going to be greater than or equal to. Notice how we reverse the inequality symbol, and this would be positive 3. So notice that 3 does satisfy this inequality because 3 is greater than or equal to positive 3. So to show that 3 is in the interval, we make a closed point on 3. And then for values greater than positive 3, we have an arrow to the right. Now it's extremely important to remember that these two inequalities are connected by the word or. The solution is x is less than 4 or x is greater than or equal to 3. Which means as long as a value is in either of these intervals, it satisfies the compound inequality. Graphically, that means as long as the value is graphed at least once, it would be considered part of the solution. Well, every single value on the number line here is graphed at least once. This blue interval here is graphed once, this small region here is graphed twice, and this red region over here is graphed once. So every single number on the number line would actually satisfy this compound inequality. So we need to graph the entire number line. So let's go ahead and clear this. So to graph the entire number line, we'll just shade the entire number line with arrows in both directions. So that also tells us that, which means instead of expressing our solution using inequalities like this, we can just say the solution would be all real numbers. And then for interval notation, to the right we're approaching positive infinity, and to the left we're approaching negative infinity. So interval notation for all real numbers would be from negative infinity to positive infinity. So it is important that we recognize this inequality as an or, because if it was an and, it would have just been the overlapping interval. But in this case, because it's an or, it's actually all real numbers.